So hi, welcome to the Perception ROS course in Robot Ignite Academy. This course is made for people that want to introduce themselves into the Perception ROS Perception packages, and especially in robotics perception in general. So the first thing is talk about the platform that we're going to use. We're going to use Robot Ignite Academy platform for learning ROS. For that, you have to go to theconstruct.com and there click on Robot Ignite Academy and then log in if you already have an account, and if you don't, sign up for free. Once you're there, you're going to go to this webpage, which is Robot Ignite Academy webpage, and inside it you have all the courses available. So we are going to select ROS Perception in 5 days. You start the course and you'll be greeted with a screen more or less like this one. So you have a notebook where you have all the explanations and code that you will need to learn, in this case, perception. Then you have an IDE with your files, your file tree here, which is a reflection of your user workspace, of Catkin workspace in this case. Here you have the editing space, then you have the web shells, you have 4 web shells available, and then you have the simulation. You can give us feedback through this button here, and then you can also select the unit that you want to do. In this case, we want the first one, so it starts there. And in case you, for example, you finish, in unit 3, then when you go back again, you will start in unit 3. And then finally, you have some options here to change the layout. For example, if you want to see the simulation in the center, or you want the web shell longer, in this case, this is the one I prefer. And then you can maximize each window separately, like this. And that's quite it. The rest of the system is exactly the same way as you would use it in your local computer. So you have the web shells, you have ROS installed, and all the simulations running. In each unit, you will probably change of simulation, depending on the course. In this course, you'll change of simulation quite often. And that's it. So let's start with the course. So, why do you want to learn perception? Well, basically, perception is very important to have a useful robot. So it's been a lot of the research in robotics has been done in this matter. Why? Because you can have a very good robot, but if it doesn't have perception, if it can't understand the world that is around it, it's useless most of the time. So this course will give you the tools to start in perception. Perception is a really big topic, and you wouldn't finish it in only a course. You need several courses to have a wide understanding of all the topics that perception talks about. This course is a basic one for people that start, or people that know perception but don't know how to use it in ROS. So, the first thing we're going to do is see a demo of what you can do with perception. So here we have a simulation with, let's do it a bit bigger, there we go. So here you have a very simple robot called Mira, which has 2 eyes, a very small camera here, and it can move the head around in roll, pitch, and yaw. And then you have a red ball. And that's quite it. So what we want to do is track the ball, the red ball, so that Mira can always look at the, it's looking always to the red ball. So let's have a look. So the first thing we have to do is click on the graphical tools icon. So you have here graphical, open graphical interface. This would be like plugging a screen to the servers that you're using. So as you can see here, there's already something executing. So you can see the camera, what the camera of Mira is seeing, and you see you have the red ball and a red box around it. That's because it's doing blob tracking. It's tracking colors, blobs of colors, and in this case it's tracking the red blob, or all the colors that represent this red ball. So let's close this because we don't need it anymore. There we go. So now, let's follow the instructions. So the first thing you have to do is move the ball with a keyboard. So what we're going to do is I'm going to put this here, and I'm going to put this here, and then I'm going to execute the command. So let's put the simulation, there we go. I'm going to execute the command that allows me to move the ball around. I'm going to lower the speed so that it makes it a bit easier for Mira to track the ball. You lower it pressing in the keyboard the Z, and we move around. So as you can see, the ball is moving around and Mira is tracking the ball. So let's have a better look here. So as you can see, Mira is turning around the head, tracking the ball. So if, for example, we change, it should continue tracking. So as you can see, it's the eyes there are tracking the ball. And that's it. So this is an example of blob tracking. So we're going to stop this. Okay, perfect. Then we're going to get this here again. And there you go. So you have seen an example of blob tracking is the most basic example of perception, of robot perception in general. So what are you going to learn? You're not going to learn only blob tracking, so you're going to learn how to use OpenCV, the basics of OpenCV in ROS. OpenCV, for the people that don't know, it's a humongous library for vision, especially for vision. And it's used everywhere in robotics and in many other applications. So it's really important that you know how to use it in ROS. Then, more specifically, you're going to learn how to track objects using blobs. You can track objects in many ways. This is the most basic and easy way of doing it. Then, we're going to learn how to follow lines using an RGB camera. So we're going to use the things that you've learned of OpenCV and blob tracking to follow lines. The example, the classic example of following lines. Then we're going to concentrate on people interactions. So all the things related to people. So detect human faces. We're going to recognize different faces. So you can detect human faces, but then you have to know who that person is. So that's face recognition. Then we're going to learn how to track a person in three-dimensional space. That means that you can follow a person through an environment. And then we're going to learn how to do object recognition and surface recognition. Object recognition based on patterns, not in colors or blobs, but in the pattern of the object. This is important to know because you can do blob tracking objects if the objects have this morphology, like red. So it's really easy to track. But if it's a more complex object, you need object recognition. And then you need also flat surfaces recognition to know where you can find the objects, where to place objects, and so on. It's really useful in robotics. And finally, you're going to recognize objects in three-dimensional space, so with point cloud. Which this, what's the difference? Well, this, you can recognize an object, but you don't know where it is. With point cloud sensors, you can recognize the object and position it in space. So then you can add all your grabbing and grasping algorithms to get the object. So how are you going to learn all this? Well, if you've done more courses in Robot Ignite, you will know that all these courses are based on practice and hands-on experience, because we believe that is the only way to know how to use robotics, how to learn robotics in a very efficient way. So you're going to use several simulations. The first one will be Mira robot that you've seen already. Then you're going to use a Kabuki robot with some lines on the floor for the line following learning. Then you're going to use, on the rest of the simulations, you're going to use the fetch robot with different environments. So this one is the object recognition environment, and then you'll have several environments for face recognition, face detection, and people tracking. And finally, for the project, you will use a simplified version of the Aibo robot dog of Sony. Talking about the project will be, it's used to practice all the things that you've learned throughout the course. You can practice them on your own in a concise and precise project, and you can do anything you want, but you have like tasks, and each task is based on one topic. So you'll have one task for object recognition, for people tracking, and so on. Okay, so the requirements for doing this course will be, you need to know ROS basics. We suppose that if you're doing this course, you know already ROS. If you don't, please, before doing this course, do the ROS Basics in 5 days course that we have in Robot Ignite, and then return to this course. Then you need some knowledge of TFs and URDF robot creation. If you don't, please do the courses on that matter. Then you need some Python basic knowledge, and it's highly advisable that you also have some basic knowledge of robot perception. And finally, you need some PID theoretical knowledge of how it works, and essentially knowing why you need them, because we are going to need them in the following line unit. And finally, special thanks for a lot of people that have made this course possible. Thanks to University of Lincoln, for this amazing algorithms for tracking persons and so on. We are going to use that. Also, thanks to Alonso Martinez for designing and creating the physical robot Mira, in which you have just seen. Then some face recognition modules that these people made, then also blob tracking, also to these guys that have done it very well, then also the designs of eyeball and the eyeball bone also, IntroLab for the object recognition system, Maker Humans for the software that allowed us to create all these people, and finally, and more important, thanks to the ROS community, the OSRF and Gazebo team for making ROS platforms and Gazebo simulator available to everyone. So after this, let's start. To start, just you have to click next, and I'll see you in the next unit.